February, so I'm here for you guys today with a favorites video. I haven't done a favorites video for January just because I've uploaded my makeup collection. If you haven't seen it, I will link it down below. But this month I definitely have some favorite products I would like to share with you guys. First of all, my face routine has changed a little bit. I always used my YSL Touche Eclat, but now I have switched to the Missha BB Cream. That's the perfect cover BB Cream number 23. I love this BB Cream just for the simple fact that it has high SPF in it. It's perfect to wear for every day. It's easy to apply with my fingers and it lasts all day for me. My face primer has also changed. I've been using a lot the Dior Pore Minimizer, which I think does a great job to fill in my pores and fine lines. If you like the Benefit Professional, the Dior is definitely a great alternative. It also keeps my foundation on a little longer and it keeps my oils around my nose and in my T-zone controlled. Yeah, it's a great primer and these two in combination have been working really nicely for me. And another product I would like to talk about again is the Hourglass number 28 Serum Primer. This has been a savior on my dry areas on the face, especially above my lips. I'm dry at the moment, and also underneath the eyes. I just basically apply it once I've done my eye makeup. I do my eye makeup first. Then I apply this, let it sink in for about 10 minutes, and then I go over with my other face product. It's a really nice product if you would like to add something moisturizing into your face routine because it does hydrate amazingly. The two blushes which basically have been my go-to is one drugstore and one high-end. The drugstore is my Alverde Flamingo. This is the blush I wore nearly every day and also a blush I would like to use up this year. It's a great blush, easy to apply, more on the sheerer side, so you know you can't overdo it. With this blush you are definitely on the safe side. Beautiful color blush, especially I always tend to go for these sort of red, raspberry red colors this time of the year or in the colder months. And my new Tom Ford blush in 05 Ravish, oh my god. Guys, if you haven't tried Tom Ford blushes, I can't believe it took me so long to try these blushes. They are amazing. I'm wearing it on my cheeks again today. Ever since I got it, I have been loving it so much. Not only the color, I really like the Tom Ford blush formula a lot. This is what it looks like. Again, more of a red toned color, but a little bit more terracotta than the Alverde blush. Even though it was so expensive, I haven't regretted one single bit that I picked it up. Then I've been trying a new mascara I haven't tried before, and it's the Buxom, which one is that? Lash Mascara. Mascara seals black as black. It makes my lashes really black. It combs them out nicely and separates them. This is what the mascara looks like. I have 3 or 4 coats on at the moment and it still doesn't clump up. Such an amazing mascara. Unfortunately, I only have a sample, but this is definitely one I would get in full size. And the brush is really nice also. It's an hourglass shaped brush. It's rubber bristles. And this has definitely been one of my best new discoveries the last couple of months. I love this mascara. I'm really sad when I will run out of it because I only have a sample size, but I will track it down here in the UK and see where I can get it over here because it is that good. As for eyeshadows, one go-to eyeshadow quad is again from Tom Ford and it's Orchid Haze. This is what I'm wearing on my eyes again today. I love the Orchid Haze eyeshadow quad. It's definitely one of the best Tom Ford quads in my opinion. So easy to wear and easy to apply for a simple everyday look. You can go a little bit smokier or you can just keep it neutral with this eye quad. It's been in many favorite videos and yeah, there's a reason for it. And also I can combine this quad with any kind of lipstick. A brighter one, a nude one, a pink one, a peachy one. Anything goes with that. And the other two eyeshadows from MAC I have been using a lot is MAC Vanilla. This is basically the eyeshadow I always use for my brow bone. Or I've also enjoyed using that all over the lid. Basically just an off-white color and it's really nice for my skin type to use on the brow bone or all over the lid. MAC Vanilla is really nice. However, once I've used this one up, I think I will switch to Blanc type because I just like the texture of Blanc type a little bit better. It's one of the MAC matte squares, I think, and this one is a velvet. The other eyeshadow I've been really enjoying is MAC Cork. And this one I have been enjoying actually as a bronzer also. I like to contour with this or bronze up my face, just basically warm up my face with it. Use it lightly, not full on my face or even in the crease. I can pack it on the outer corner to darken it up a little bit or just blend it in the crease. Very, very nice versatile eyeshadow by MAC. And also same sort of look with a lighter lid and a deeper crease. My new Makeup Forever eyeshadow trio. The colors I have are really nice. I'm happy with all three shades in it. And the one I like most is this one. I think it's called M600 Pink Brown. Beautiful. The Makeup Forever matte eyeshadow formula is so great. Because again, this is so versatile. You can really pack it on and make it dark. Or it, use it as a liner even. Or you can blend it out so nicely that it's a lot sheerer. So I can use it for the crease or all over the lid. And the other lid color I have really been loving is the light one, and that's I526, I believe is the number. It's an amazing eyeshadow all over the lid because it's not quite matte and it's not quite shimmery either. So these two I loved really a lot wearing in combination. Or the two MAC ones. Here's MAC Vanilla, MAC Cork, the Makeup Forever M600 and Makeup Forever I526. But easy to wear, and I've really been enjoying easygoing, everyday, wearable eye looks a lot. The last couple of months, really. And for an easygoing, wearable eye look, I also have been enjoying wearing pencils instead of gel liners. I am normally a gel liner girl. 3 or 4 months back, I thought I would like to use up some of my pencils, and I've really been enjoying them. And this one is a perfect shade also because it's not too dark and not too light. That's Stray Dog by Urban Decay, one of the 24/7 pencils, and it's a little bit taupey. Just put it on the lower lash line, drag it out here, line my eyes quickly, smudge it out with any kind of eyeshadow. It worked great with the Orchid Haze, which is a little bit more on the purpley side. It worked great with the Makeup Forever. It worked great with MAC Cork, which is a medium warm brown shade. Works great with so many eyeshadows if you want to set that liner. Oh, by the way, I've done a review on the Makeup Forever eyeshadows. I will link it down below just in case you haven't seen it. And for lips, again, I've enjoyed my easygoing lip color and nude lip color. Two nudes I really like are the Viva Glam 2 by MAC. This is what I'm wearing on my lips again today. I love this lipstick. It's one of my favorite MAC lipsticks. And I haven't used it much in the last year or so, and I decided I need to use it more because I think it just looks great on me. It's a perfect nude shade for me. The Viva Glam 2 MAC lipstick has been a favorite of mine for so long and an all-time favorite MAC lipstick. The other nude lipstick I liked was a little bit more of a pinkier color, and that's the Estee Lauder Pure Color Envy in Desirable. This one is pretty similar to MAC Cream Cup, I think. It's just a very easygoing pinky nude. A lot more pink than the Viva Glam 2. Let me do a swatch of that also. There it is. The Viva Glam 2 is definitely more rosy. And one new lipstick formula I've been trying out recently are the Bite Beauty High Pigmented Pencils. And the color I really liked was Winterberry. They smell nice, they taste nice, they feel nice on the lips, they go on nice. It's so annoying that we can't get Bite Beauty here in the UK, except of ordering through Sephora. I think that Sephora ships to the UK these Bite Beauty products. Oh my god, I really would like to try out now their lip gloss. I want to try out the lipsticks. And there's a reason why there's a hype going on about the Bite Beauty lip products, because they are really nice. Oh my god. And here is the color. If I wanted to wear something a little bit more daring, this was what I was wearing. And the last favorite for this month definitely were my Takumi brushes by Chikuhodo. I love these brushes. They are really soft. Not as soft as squirrel, but they apply makeup really nicely because they are dense, but not as dense that you look cakey or that it packs on product so that you can't blend it out anymore. These brushes are really fantastic for any kind of powder. It doesn't matter if it's highly pigmented or not so pigmented. I love the softness of them. I love the unique shapes they have. Chikuhodo definitely has done it again. And the brushes I really like out of that line is one is my T4. It's dirty now, sorry, I've used it. the T4, which is basically a round egg shaped. It's not really tapered, it's round. And the other one, which I think is really unique, and I just, oh, I like the look of this brush because it's so huge and fluffy, is the T1. Ah, oh, these Takumis are amazing brushes. The eyeshadow brushes are really amazing too. These are the two, especially the T8. I love this brush for the outer corner or just lower lash line work. These Takumis definitely have done it for me. And that's it, you guys. These have been the products I have been using a lot. I've basically been using very simple makeup because I've got lots going on at the moment. It's great to be busy, and I will give you an update of what has been going on once everything is a little bit more organized. There's definitely something I need to tell you guys, and I really look forward to that. But for now, we are at the end of the video. As always, guys, thank you so much for watching. Lots of love. Until next time, from Cornelia.